described in Captioned Media Program. In the classroom and online, dcmp.org.
Rewind Button, produced by Parsons and Warde Productions. Written by Hillary Parsons Keys, CTVI, Julie Glover, COMS. Captioning services provided by Caption Perfect. Caption editors, Will Hallman and Aaron Gibbs.
Emily sweeps the sidewalk with a white cane.
Have you ever just wanted a rewind button? Emily gets two rewinds as she walks to Lisa's house.
She walks with a cane.
Part one, refuse politely.
Hey, Emily, it's George from 3rd period. I was going to go catch the bus. I was wondering if you had change for a 20.
Yeah, sure.
Sweet.
Oh. Is that it?
George counts about $27.
Yeah.
The video plays backwards.
Rewind.
The money passes back to Emily.
Emily remembers a lesson.
Okay, Levy, we're going to go shopping. Let's look at your money.
In the memory, Emily takes out a wad of folded bills.
Okay, so we need to separate them. Okay, the first bill you have over here is a one. So we can fold it. We're going to fold the bills in different ways. And you can do it any way you want to. Let me have this money. You can decide to keep the bill, the ones, straight, or you can decide to fold them lengthwise like this. Okay? And so when you have them in your wallet, you know this is a
one.
A one. That's right. Okay. So we're going to keep this as a one. All right. Your next bill is a five.
Emily separates the five from the wad of bills.
All right, let me fold it for you. So those we can fold.
Emily folds it in half along the short dimension.
See the difference?
Mm-hmm.
This is a one and this is
a
five.
Folded, they have different shapes.
Remember how you fold your money. And remember, it's very important that you don't make change for anybody.
Back with George.
I was wondering if you had change for a 20.
No, sorry, I don't have any.
George trudges off.
All right, see you later.
Watch that cane.
He trips on it and she smacks his back with it.
Hey, are you blind or something?
Rewind. Part two. Think before you act. Emily remembers another lesson. That guy just pushed past Emily. Uh-oh.
Emily, wait. Now, what did just happen?
I just tripped a jerk.
And why did you do that?
Because he's a jerk.
Well, maybe so. But that doesn't give you the right to do that. Besides, we don't want any confrontation with strangers. You don't know this person. We don't know what he's capable of. And it's not worth it. Okay?
Okay.
Back with George. He trips.
What's up with that?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Emily arrives at a house. She wears an orange t-shirt with a purple and green skirt.
Emily finally gets to Lisa's house. All the lessons are over. Or are they?
She rings the bell.
Gee, those colors look hideous together. Part three. Style matters.
Lisa opens the door.
What are you wearing?
Why, Adam?
Really, an orange shirt and a purple and green skirt and shoes, really?
Yeah.
I can't go to the mall with you like this.
Why not? I look awesome.
Because it's embarrassing. It really is. I really don't want people to make fun of you or me. So, do you want to borrow some clothes?
Sure.
Okay, thank you. Here, come here. I'll go to my room and we'll get some clothes.
Later, Emily wears a white t-shirt and denim shorts. She and Lisa step out.
Ta-da! Emily no longer looks hideous.
Lisa wears a red tee and jeans.
See, Emily, don't you like your outfit? Don't you feel more comfortable?
Yeah. See, now whenever we go shopping and everything, you won't get made fun of and we'll look really nice and presentable.
You'll never believe what happened to me on the way here.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free-loaned, described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved list of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.